Good job. Good afternoon, everybody. As Al, Peter, and Jim have described, our 2007 Lincoln vehicles are perfectly designed and engineered to deliver a unique experience for our Lincoln buyers. Now, we want to take some time out now to show you how we're planning to communicate these things to our customers as we move forward. Now, let's begin by taking a look at the segmentations of the luxury market. Starting there, it helps us zero in on what distinguishes the Lincoln customer and how best to communicate with them as we go forward. Now, we believe there are three separate segments of the luxury industry. First, there's what we call the old world luxury. It's very traditional, it's formal, and it's most often affiliated with the European brands, and it really takes its cues from Europe. Think about Prince Charles to kind of personify that. The second is the money is everything luxury segment, which can be viewed as excessive, overt, and ostentatious. Here you can think about somebody like, say, Donald Trump, right? And then there is the American dream luxury segment, which can be defined as approachable, contemporary or modern, and casual. Here I'd encourage you to think about someone like Oprah Winfrey or maybe Ralph Lauren. This is the target for Lincoln. This is the segment with which Lincoln is clearly most closely associated and where we choose to compete. The customers in this segment have a unique set of core beliefs, and this is very interesting. And these beliefs differentiate them from the rest of the luxury segments. They are self-made, optimistic people for whom life is all about and they believe full of opportunity. They're confident and they're hardworking and they set their sights on realistic objectives and goals. They believe that success deserves to be rewarded, but not in a self-indulgent, outwardly focused way. And this is important. You heard Peter say earlier, they don't need to scream their success or shout their success. We also know that these core beliefs generate a unique set of values that match those of the Lincoln customer. And this is very important for us because these American dream consumers are genuine, they're confident, they're optimistic, independent, and you can see how they contrast against some of the other values in the luxury segments in that slide. At Lincoln, our goal is to earn reward status with this group of consumers in everything we do. You can see how that contrasts with our competitors, I said a second ago. Now, interestingly, that reward has both a rational side and an emotional side. On the rational side, our customers choose our products because they value the features, design, and the award-winning quality. And you heard Al mention some of those awards earlier. Our products meet their rational decision-making criteria, if you will, which is very important. And on an emotional level, our brand is aspirational and stands for values similar to those of our customers. And shared values are about as strong a connection as we could possibly make with our buyers. When we bring this emotional circle together with the product and rational circle, we get the brand resonance we're seeking at Lincoln. And this is the messaging that we are communicating through our Dreams campaign. Let me show you what we mean. We brought this to life in a spot for Navigator you may have seen already, but it features Dwayne Wade, superstar for the Miami basketball team, which you'll see now. So take a quick look at this ad.
Hey, what's up?
It's D. Wade.
I can use some help.
It's heavy.
Yes, it is.
My dream is to leave the world a better place than I found it.
Good job, buddy.
Yo! Hey, coach.
The new 2007 Lincoln Navigator with enough room for a basketball team. Life's calling. Where to next?
Okay, that's how we introduced the new Navigator. Now, a couple things. First of all, in that ad, you clearly saw an aspirational individual in an aspirational vehicle showing off the product. But you also saw Dwayne Wade doing something important, giving back. And that's a value that's important to our consumers. in a way in which we try to resonate with them. Now, this next ad, you see the same sort of approach, but at a different value and a different subject. Take a look at this. We call it commute.
I gotta run.
Bye, Dad.
Bye, honey.
The 2007 Lincoln MKZ with a powerful new 3.5-liter engine and available all-wheel drive.
Hey, Grace, any phone calls?
A driving experience so exciting, it makes every commute a dream.
Morning, Mr. Johnson.
Grace?
Hi, boss.
Johnson?
My dream, to have the best office in town.
Hey, boss. Want a baguette?
I can take an early lunch.
Life's calling. Where to next?
Okay, so here again, vehicle being showcased, aspirational setting. But in commute, it's not the father striving for the best office that matters. It's where that office happens to be, right? At home. Why? To be with his family. The final commercial, actually, I think we'll show you two more. The next one I want to show you is starring celebrity chef Rocco DiSpirito. If you don't know him, he's done television shows, he's got his own radio program, very well known. Take a quick look at this. This is him preparing for a typical night at the restaurant.
Tutti chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, donne ragazzi, vecchie fanciulle, ho la parrucca, presto la parola.
The all-new Lincoln MKX. Beauty, luxury, and all the fresh air you'll ever need.
My dream is to work hard for the best life has to offer.
Life's calling. Where to next?
Okay, we're changing actually with that last line of that ad, just for the record, but you can see here, same thing, demonstrates the product. Again, Rocco loves sharing his passion for cooking with others and goes to extra effort, work hard to deliver, to make sure his presentations are perfect. Now, it turns out, I guess we don't have the fourth ad I was going to show you, but it's the other MKX ad, but that'll be next time. But okay, so that kind of some of the background on how we're trying to communicate with our customers. Our campaigns, though, clearly are not all about television, right? We've employed a fully integrated campaign that reaches our customers through their lifestyle, passions, and targeted places where they consume media, through experiential events, on the web, and about every other major media there is, especially this year. Over the next 12 months, by the way, we'll spend more in promoting this Lincoln brand than ever before in its history. So we're making a big splash in just about every media there is. Our results are starting to show. We've already had 140,000 hand raisers for the new Lincoln products. We've also performed in just a few short weeks in something we have a Lincoln tour going on right now, over 5,000 test drives. And that's astronomical for the short amount of time we've been out there. We've had more than 200,000 click-throughs on our websites. And as you see in front of you right now, there's several pieces, a few pieces anyway. The big book is one that's going to be delivered to 600,000 people in the month of November as well, in terms of pieces, just to help support the brand and get us out there. So heavy-duty impact for sure. And there's one more thing that we're very excited about. We're in development of a website right now that will extend the Dreams campaign to the internet in an even grander way. Our plan is to create a community of shared dreams and provide content from experts about how one goes about reaching a particular specific dream. For instance, if a person has a dream to run a marathon, they can visit our website, view a short video with an expert marathoner telling his own story or her own story about reaching that goal, and then we'll have all the information people need to start down the path to achieve that goal themselves. This is why we're doing this. The fact of the matter is that today, typical internet banner ads lack effectiveness. What we need to do is attract consumers based upon their interest and let them step from there, being these dream sites, to our product sites when they're ready on their own terms. And this is going to be a huge effort that's going to get a lot of attention. There'll be a lot of launch activity on this in the very near term. So in all, we think it's exciting stuff. I especially do. I can't wait to tell you more and show you more, but that will come later this month when we launch the site and many other activities for the Lincoln brand. For now, let me thank you for allowing you to share my enthusiasm for the Lincoln brand. I look forward to spending time with you tonight and throughout the rest of the program. And now, we get to start wrapping up, and so I call Mark up to take you through getting on the road, which is I know what you want to do. So, Mark.
Hey, thank you very much, Mike.